Well, it all started by being at Kleinfeld. And you know, it wasn't easy to get into Kleinfeld. I was already the leading designer in Israel. And I had a huge fashion show that I showed in LA. And it was so successful that my husband, who is my partner, David, who is my partner in the business, said, there's something here. There's a huge potential. We need to get you out of Israel into the world. And of course, you know, New York, if you can make it here, you can really make it anywhere. I don't know if you guys are aware of that. But coming from another country to this amazing, powerful city, this doesn't exist anywhere. I lived in Paris for 10 years. I traveled the world. I've seen, I think, every continent. This city is magic. All you need to do is believe in your dreams, and they really do happen. And because they happened here, I am now very successful worldwide. So I was at Kleinfeld. I had my own boutique at Kleinfeld. After, you have to understand, they threw me out of the store when I came for the first time 13 years ago.
I was going to say, I read that they thought your looks were too sexy.
They literally told me, don't call us, we'll call you. We don't sell lingerie. My dresses were so sexy at the time because the Israeli bride is more of a, you know, daring and I would say on the border of provocative. So when I came with these dresses, these, you know, plunging necklines, low backs, corsets, lace-up corsets, they looked at it, they said, what is this? And I was so stubborn because, you see, with me, when you throw me out of the door, I have a tendency to come back through the window. So you have to shut the windows if you really don't want me there. But that's what I did. And I sent them another collection, which I adapted it more to the American bride, but still gave my touch of sexiness. And I asked them to put the dresses on the floor for a week and see if they sell or not. And 2 weeks later, the owner of Kleinfeld, Mara Urschel, calls me and says, I think we have a problem with your dresses. And I said, no. Okay, what's the problem? What can I help you with? And she said, we are selling so many, I'm not sure that you can manufacture as many. And I said, well, don't worry. Don't worry. And I immediately started recruiting the whole country to work for me because it was really happening. And Say Yes to the Dress started filming, I think, 10 years ago. And I already had my boutique inside of Kleinfeld. Mm-hmm. And whenever a bride was in my dress, which I would say 8 out of 10 brides are in my dresses. You can see that on the show. Mm-hmm. They would call me to the set and just film me working with the bride because it's authentic, it's real. Mm-hmm. It's not scripted. And that's what I love about it.